Ladies and gentlemen, I am SidAlpha, and it's rare that I'm placed into a position of having to create a third video for a particular developer who finds themselves on the list of the dirty devs. But when you are faced with a developer who continues to exhibit some of the worst behavior imaginable within the games industry, who continues to lie, to make threats, infringe upon and possibly steal other people's content and pass it off as their own, while, and even go so far as to misrepresent the law in order to bludgeon others on the internet, all one can do is provide the information and do one's best to make sure people are aware of what is happening and why. Because that is exactly what has been happening over the course of the past few days with Varius Benson and his game CivilContract. Now, we've already gone over the DMCA abuse and threats Varius Benson leveraged against Psy Syndicate and Big Fry TV in previous videos. If you somehow missed those, I will link them in the upper right corner of the screen, and you will be able to find them in the description down below. However, there are two new topics that I feel warrant discussion here, and that is Varius Benson's use of game assets that he had no legal right to, and also his continued harassment and legal threats leveraged against a now former community manager. So first, let's talk about Benson's use of assets. Last week, it was discovered that there were multiple assets contained within the game, and even contained within the screenshots shown on the store page that bore a striking similarity to assets used within the video game Squad. A Squad, if you haven't heard of it, is a tactical first-person shooter developed by Offworld Industries that was released in 2015 and is an extremely well-liked game. Sitting at an overall user review score on the Steam storefront of 85% positive with over 28,000 reviews and an impressive 95% positive review rating over the past 30 days. Suffice to say, if you're interested in a good tactical FPS, Squad would probably be a good choice. The first and primary focus here will be from this screenshot on the Steam store page, which seemed to be a wholesale rip of a compound and ground textures from the Narva map in Squad. This information was kept quiet while several individuals contacted a representative from Offworld Industries, and we kept a lid on the information and allowed them time to investigate. Offworld Industries recognized a large amount of assets and full-on maps being ripped from their game, which prompted Offworld Industries to approach Varius Benson with a choice: either remove all OWI assets used or license them. Of course, this sort of thing is not uncommon, as Squad itself has a modding platform that runs on the Unreal Engine that allows game developers to create their own projects. This custom platform is designed specifically for modding. However, if a developer chooses to use those assets within their own game, they would be in violation of copyright if a license agreement is not reached for the use of those assets. Now, I hate to use the term to be fair, but to be fair, there has been a great deal of confusion for some modders and developers in the past as a result of articles such as this one on 80th Level titled "Using Squad Mod Kit for Game Development." However, within even that article, it is stated, "The rules are that there should be no ripped assets and no copyright infringement, as well as keeping the mods within Steam's guidelines for appropriate content. Other than that, modders are free to make whatever they like using our SDK, so long as our assets stay within our game. Allowing modders creative freedom is very important to us, and we feel it's one of the reasons that projects like Postscriptum can succeed." And Postscriptum started off as a mod itself, however, due to their interactions and work involved, Offworld Industries ended up partnering with them and helped them to publish the game. In addition to the Narva map, it was stated that the Scorpo map was also likely to have been wholesale ripped and had some assets removed, potentially with the intent of hiding that fact. And after discussions had concluded, the Offworld Industries representative returned to us with a brief official statement. The developer was asked to remove Squad content, he agreed, and said he removed it. However, whether this has been done or not remains to be seen, and even if the assets have been removed from the game, several Squad-owned assets are still being advertised on the Steam storefront for the CivilContract video game. And I find it ironic, to say the least, that Varius Benson attempted to weaponize copyright law to force down videos critical of himself and of his game while concurrently utilizing multiple assets that were not his own and that he held no legal right to make use of. Now, I also wanted to talk about Varius Benson and his continued actions of harassment, misrepresentations, and legal threats against the now former community manager Jamie that I had referenced in previous videos. I say former due to his leaving the team. Now, to hear Varius Benson tell it, Benson terminated Jamie due to his being too slow to respond, too slow to complete simple tasks, and was unprofessional. Also, in response to one person asking why Jamie was upset, Benson stated that he believed it was due to Jamie being removed and not wanting to lose the position. However, as with anything Varius Benson says, the truth is usually sold separately. such as within this screenshot where Benson attempts to spin a bit of sob story within it. He specifically states, "I would appreciate it if you could rethink your choice of leaving. I understand I snapped and I shouldn't have, but you did also F me around." Of course, since then, things had obviously gone downhill, such as this statement that Jamie had breached a non-disclosure agreement after the separation, which was further clarified that Jamie had apparently disclosed information regarding private messages, which Jamie confirmed with me that the discussion with the individual called Stryker was regarding why Jamie was no longer a community manager. Although in my conversation with Jamie, he had stated that he had gotten fired, so whether he left or was fired, it would seem perhaps a little of both was true. In that regard. Benson then demanded a list of everyone Jamie had breached NDA with, then continued on to threaten a lawsuit and also threatened to send Jamie's parents to jail. Bear in mind, Jamie is 17 years of age. At my recommendation, Jamie blocked Benson on Discord due to the constant statements such as this, and finding no avenue there, Benson took to messaging Jamie via Steam instead, with this image in which Benson threatens Jamie's reputation due to the size of Benson's community. Benson then stated that Jamie was ruining his own reputation by not taking the second chance offered to have him come back. Then Benson posted a screenshot claiming that a friend had ratted him out and that he would definitely be taking legal action. That screenshot actually shows this image, simply stating that a person under the age of 18 can't sign a non-disclosure agreement. And again, in another screenshot, Benson is being highly vitriolic and threatening Jamie's parents, yet again. It continues with statements that blocking him will not stop his lawyers. Now, yes, non-disclosure agreements exist for a reason, and threatening legal action when someone violates an NDA isn't necessarily a bad thing. However, Benson himself has lied so often and so repeatedly in regards to each and every individual that has ever been perceived as damaging his own reputation that he loses any and all moral high ground in these matters. Also, I did obtain a copy of this non-disclosure agreement, and this is about as far from an executable contract as one could possibly imagine. So while the teenager Varius Benson rails on about these attorneys he seems to claim to have, let's talk a bit about why this is not a valid contract. I mean, aside from the simple fact that it's a Word document and the placeholder fields are left as placeholders, let's take a look at the legality standpoint. First, the age involved for Jamie. Now, Jamie, as stated, is a 17-year-old. In the UK, where Jamie resides, as well as within Australia, where Benson resides, and where we will assume Benson is intending this contract to be executed, Jamie is considered to be a minor. Now, some people, such as Benson, will assume that if a minor signs a contract, the parent or legal guardian are liable should that minor breach that contract. However, in Australian law, there is a little thing referred to as capacity to consent, and it is recognized in Australian law that minors, meaning individuals under the age of 18, have a restricted capacity in that regard, and per legal vision, under the Minors Property and Contracts Act, minors are only bound to contracts that are for their benefit at the time of formation. So under that aspect, this is not a legally actionable non-disclosure agreement, but that's not the only reason this contract is invalid. Because you also have to bear in mind that Varius Benson, at the time this contract was signed, was also a minor, and as such could be considered to have a restricted capacity to consent. Although if you'll notice, Varius Benson did not actually sign the contract. He signed it, or rather typed, CapitalgamingRP, which again, under Australian law, is not considered a valid signature and therefore, this contract cannot legally be executed. And thanks to Legal Vision again, we can discuss exactly why this is the case. It is because no individual on the part of the development company actually signed the contract. In order to use the company name, you would actually be using the common seal, which usually contains the company's ACN and the company's registered name. However, even in that instance, it would still require the signature of the sole director of the company. It needs a person to sign the document. It needs a director. It needs an officer of the company that is allowed to be able to sign legal contracts on behalf of that company. This is in no way a valid contract for multiple reasons, and yet Benson keeps yammering on how he will sue the parents, put them in jail, leverage a fine against them, all sorts of nonsense, and all because an unscrupulous developer prone to lying to such an extent that it dips into the territory of being pathological in nature couldn't keep from being so spiteful and vitriolic over what amounted to a minor incident of a teenage boy not being there at Benson's beck and call due to the simple fact that he was having dinner with his family. Of course, this is the same developer that said, and I quote, "One day Big Fry or SidAlpha will poke the wrong bear and will pay." I have been speaking to my lawyers this morning to sort things out, and they said there is so much someone could get Big Fry for, and quoted, they said SidAlpha could get a major lawsuit under his belt if this continues. Now, I don't fancy a lawsuit against Big Fry as well, he's not worth it, but if he does really go through with this, I will without a doubt counter him. So I will say this to Varius Benson, you want me, come and get me. I will put my direct email address up on the screen. Give that to these alleged lawyers and have them send me an email. Unlike the two people in Benson's Discord that attempted to dox me with personal information that hasn't been current in nearly two decades and also threatened to swat me, which prompted my notifying the authorities as I wouldn't want the poor soul who might happen to live at that apartment's address currently to have anything bad happen to them, unlike them, I will be more than happy to provide these alleged lawyers with current and accurate contact information so that I can be legally served court documents and paperwork. Varius Benson likes to talk about suing people. He likes to make threats. He likes to bully people while under the very false assumption that he somehow has the upper hand. Well, Benson, go right ahead. If you want to come after me, I will in no way stop you from the attempt. In fact, I will be glad for it. But sooner or later, people like Benson will come to realize that all of the threats and extortion attempts in the world stop working really damn quick once people call them out on their own crap and refuse to kowtow to their deplorable actions and behavior. Ask Andrew Watt how well that worked out for him when he made threats of lawsuits over defamation when the claimed defamation was simply factual information. Ask Matt Norman how well it went for him for the same. Ask the Romine brothers of Digital Homicide how well it went for them when they attempted a lawsuit against Jim Sterling and also filed a lawsuit against 100 Steam users all for the same thing. You see, these people, scum as they are, really are not all that different from each other. The accents may differ, the words they utter may carry slight variations on a theme, but at the end of the day, they're all basically the same type of person. But once again, ladies and gentlemen, I am SidAlpha. Happy Thanksgiving. And I'll see you next time.